गुड इवनिंग एंड आई वेलकम यू स्टूडेंट्स। व्हाट वी आर ट्राइंग टू डू विद यू स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर एक्चुअली रिवाइजिंग द कोर्स स्टूडेंट्स। नंबर वन, रिवाइजिंग द कोर्स एंड मेनली वी आर डूइंग मोर वर्क ऑन फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री स्टूडेंट एंड वी विल बी सॉल्विंग न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑल्सो ऑन फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री। आवर पर्पज स्टूडेंट्स to do sufficient practice and solve student different type of questions students, and students I always say that we have to understand the material, no mugging is required, understand, focus, pay attention student to the question. If I don't understand a question, I will never be able to solve the question. And you have seen we are doing MCQ type of question, and MCQ question, and there is no guesswork now, because we have to solve each and every question, and who can solve it? We are trying to decode the NCERT books completely, line by line, line, word by word, word by word. It is not that line student, each word should be known to us. And the result of this will be what student? What will be the result of this? You will get 100%. Target is 100%, because it is an opportunity student. If we have more time, then opportunity increases. We can study more. We can study in depth. We can prepare for competitions. We were having less time, now we have more time. So we are focusing only on studies. Nothing else, everything we don't want to know. All our focus as a student is study. Regular study of all the subjects, all five subjects regular. This will be the, what will happen? That you are getting time, okay. You will get 100 out of 100 in all the subjects. It is possible, I'm telling you. So let us not waste our time. That is my objective student, I am telling my students. So keep yourself fit and busy and stay at home and do the course as thoroughly as possible. More difficult topics, we will do more work on them. What we were talking, student, electrochemistry is the most important topic and the largest topic you have seen. And we have told you, student, on one side we were discussing in electrochemistry, there will be very large number of questions in competitions also, electrochemistry student. And in this, there is a possibility that there will be numericals. And you have seen, student, how big is this chapter? Because you have on one side metallic conductance, then electrolytic conductance, student. And in electrolytic conductance, you have been told about conductance, cell constant, conductivity, kappa. Then we have told you molar conductivity, and we told you limiting molar conductivity, and we told you dissociation constant. All these formulas should be known to us. They will be applied to student for solving the questions. And after that, we also discuss student important, the Faraday's laws of electrolysis. They are very important. Questions will be asked. Numericals will also be asked. Students, what are the Faraday's laws of electrolysis? The amount of the substance liberated at the electrode is directly proportional to the amount of the charge passed or quantity of electricity passed. Q is equal to I into T. Q is equal to I into T. Student, all these formulas, we are aware of this now. W is equal to ZIT, the weight of the substance, and that is electrochemical equivalent constant, student, which is equal to equivalent weight by Faraday. Z is equal to equivalent weight by Faraday, that is a charge. Electrochemical equivalent is the when one coulomb of charge is passed, student, that we how much is the weight that is deposited, equivalent weight divided by the charge carried by one mole of the electron, that is one Faraday. Very important concept, the second law of Faraday, that if different amount different electrolytes are taken, same amount of charge is passed through different electrolytes at the for the same period of time, student, what happens? You have seen the amounts deposited are proportional to their equivalent weights. That is very important point, and a lot of questions are coming on that also. So, and we also defined what is one Faraday, student. One Faraday will deposit 1 gram equivalent of a substance. Very important. So we are aware of all this when I discuss all these things and what is equivalent weight, the atomic mass student, atomic mass, if you have m atomic mass divided by the n factor student. So all these things we have discussed, they are very important and minute questions. We discussed the galvanic cells, electrochemical cell, two types of cell, galvanic cells and electrolytic cell. What is the difference between two types of cell? Galvanic cell converts chemical energy into electrical energy. Electrolytic cell, you pass electric current and then chemical reaction takes place, student. So you have seen electroplating is a result of electrolytic cell. So applications are also great for electrochemistry. You are able to prepare student different types of substances, compounds by electrolysis. Electroplating can be done, refining can be done. And you can extract certain metals by this process. All these important points. So we continue with MCQ questions. MCQ questions on the topic of physical chemistry. Physical chemistry, which can be asked in the paper. The question one is on the screen, student. A new galvanic cell, student. New galvanic cell. This is our E0. E0. Is more than E naught for the Daniell cell. E naught for the Daniell cell. You know that there is some value for this, for the Daniell cell. This E naught value for the Daniell cell. You already know this is the E naught value, student, greater than the E naught value for the Daniell cell. Is connected to a Daniell cell in a manner that new cell gives electrons to cathode. What will happen? I hope you first we have to understand the question, student, before we answer any question. This is important. When we made a Daniell cell, what is a Daniell cell, student? You know, how did we made it? You had zinc 2 plus aqueous. If I have one molar, student, then what was it? Copper. There were two half cells in the Daniell cell. Am I right? Zinc half cell, and they were connected by a salt bridge, student, and they were giving a voltage of 1.10 volt. If I attach from outside a battery whose E naught is more than 1.10, then what will happen? So E naught of Daniell cell, it is more than this. Then what will happen, student? Then the current electrons will flow from battery to the cathode. What is the correct choice, student? Four choices are given, student. E cell will increase, E cell will decrease, no change. Daniell cell will work as electrolytic cell where zinc will deposit on zinc rod and copper will deposit. What is the correct answer for the students? I've given you so much information, so much clue that. Any question is coming, student. I have a picture of that in my mind. I know what is a Daniell cell and I am now attaching a battery outside the Daniell cell, so which has a E naught more than that. What will be the result of this? What is your answer, students? You will get 1 minute to answer any question. After that, I will take over. E cell will increase, that is wrong. E cell will decrease, wrong. There will be no change, wrong. And only thing is that Daniell cell will start working as electrolytic cell is correct. The reverse, you have seen when we will talk of charging and discharging. Discharging means the cell is being used and those cells which are secondary, like lead storage, what you do? You do the charging by attaching an outside battery to them, student, and then the reactions are reversed. So that is the story here. What happens, student? Electrolytic cell where zinc will deposit on zinc rod and copper will dissolve in the copper. Student, reverse reaction has started taking place. Clear? Is it okay? Tell
yes,
me.
Sir.
All right. If you have doubt, you can ask me question. No problem. And because here we are, our purpose is to revise student and discuss all the possible courses of all topics will be discussed. Next question is coming on the screen, student. But he says Ag plus A is this, iron 2 plus is minus 4.4. What is the EMF of the cell, student? This is important. How do we calculate the EMF of a cell? When we said that if there is a galvanic cell, students, I have to work, student, I cannot guess the question answer. I cannot say, oh, this is the right answer. No, how do I know? Unless I calculate. How do you calculate, student, for a galvanic cell? But here, student, what is happening? The cell, he is showing that iron is undergoing oxidation. Iron is undergoing oxidation. Why? See, important. So many questions are going to be there on this, because if I give you a question that these are the two half values, which will be anode, which will be cathode. How do we write a galvanic cell? I have told you symbolic representation. What is the symbolic representation of a galvanic cell, student? You know, anode is written on the left hand side. You have a salt bridge and cathode. Is that the way? ABC. I told you, remember ABC. Okay? Anode, cathode, and salt bridge. Right? This is the way I write. So, which will act as an anode, student, if I give you two half cells? Anode is where oxidation takes place. Anode is where oxidation takes place. Which will be oxidized, preferably? If this value is positive, this is negative. Oxidation means loss of electron. Which will lose electron more readily? Tell me, this one or this one? This value is a negative, student. This is positive. So more negative the E naught value. This is a standard reduction potential value. More negative this value, students. Mn plus 2m. More negative is this. What it means? It has more tendency to give electron. And out of the two half cell, one which has more negative value, that will act as an anode, student. So here, this value is negative, this is positive. Can you see it? Tell me yes or no. Negative. This is positive. So this will be acting as an anode. Clear? Am I right? Tell me. Do you understand what I said? This is a very important point. There will be, I discussed the variation in question, student. It is not one question, because there can be different type of questions on the same thing. Are you satisfied? Yes or no? Tell me.
Satisfied, sir.
Dekho, you have to learn, and I teach that unless my class should benefit you, students, it should not be that you are wasting your time with me. No, you should learn and able to answer the questions in the paper. That is my point. Question will be changed. I'm not saying the same question is coming. I'm saying the question is like this, it will be changed. So they will play some trick with you. But we learn it, then we can answer any question. That is my point. My job is to coach student to tell you that how you have to answer the questions, how without understanding the question and without the knowledge of the basic concepts, students, I will not be able to answer the question. Don't consider these MCQs as an easy question. My point is very clear. Are they easy? Tell me. Can I answer anything? No. There was a time when students were saying, oh, sir, four. Okay, let me guess. Still, a lot of students are doing that. You know that? Many students will guess, but that will not give any marks to them. Okay, yes, this is anode, student. That means what you are saying, that anode is on the left-hand side, student. Iron is oxidized, student. This is my salt bridge. Silver is being reduced, student. That is the way I write the cell. Is this right? Tell me, right? This reaction means this galvanic cell. And how do we calculate the E naught of the cell, student? Tell me, what is the formula? E naught right minus E naught left. Am I right?
Left, sir. Yes, sir.
So what is the value of E naught right? Which is E naught right? Silver. What is the value of silver? 0.80. Minus. What is the value of iron? Minus 0.44. Tell me, what is the value coming now? What is the answer?
Sir, answer is 1.22. 1 by 2 4.
Positive or negative?
Plus, sir, positive.
Okay. 2.4 volt. Which is the correct answer then out of the four?
B, sir.
B, okay. I have to calculate, then we will answer. I mean, I just can't say which is the answer. So we understand, then we answer every question is like this, students. You will be answering after you understand. Will not hurry up. You will get time. You will get time to answer the question. A conductivity cell containing electrons made up of gold, silver, platinized, platinum, copper. What is a conductivity cell, student? Revision. It is a complete revision of the course, student. Every question will revise the course. What is a conductivity cell, students? What do you mean by a conductivity cell? Why the conductivity cell was made, student? What was the function of the conductivity cell when we made it, student? You are aware of that? When we talked of electrolytic conductance, and I said there is a solution, student. You want to determine the conductivity of a solution. How will you determine? How will you determine the conductance? Or you have to measure the resistance of a solution. How will you measure? In physics lab, you are using Wheatstone bridge. But here we have solution. We have solution. If you have a wire, no problem. But then we made a conductivity cell. What were the electrodes, students, in the conductivity cell? You have seen they used a conductivity cell. Remember now? What was done, student? That a conductivity cell was made. And there were two electrodes, student. So inside this, we took our solution and then we connected this in the Wheatstone bridge of the physics lab, Wheatstone bridge, student, to find the resistance R of the solution. Am I right? So what were those electrodes which were used, student? Tell me, students, what were the electrodes which were used in this? What electrodes are used, students? Conductivity cell, you have 30 seconds to answer the question. Out of four, electrodes are made up of what, student? This platinized platinum, we have told you so many times.
Yes, sir.
Platinum is a very expensive metal, student, and it is why we use it so much, you know. Why do we make electrodes of platinum? Platinized means there is a powder of that, because to make it more active on the surface of the platinum. This is an inert metal, student. It doesn't react with other substances, student, if solution or anything. So this is very costly and used a lot in electrodes. Inert electrodes, student, what you have learned is inert electrodes. There are electrodes which are active electrodes. They will react themselves. Zinc, silver, copper, gold, all they are can react. Okay, next question. Which of the following expression is correct? Ka in terms of lambda 0, lambda m, where C is the molarity. In the case of the weak electrolytes, students, weak electrolytes, when we discussed the weak electrolytes, student, like acetic acid, formic acid, what happens? You said they are partially or incompletely ionized. Am I right? And how do we define Ka, student? CH3, CO minus. This is aqueous, usually. Aqueous, I'm saying aqueous has 3O. Then what happens, student? How do you define them? If alpha is the degree of dissociation, what was it? This was C1 minus alpha, this is C alpha, and this is C alpha, student. What did it become?
Yes, sir.
C alpha into C alpha and C 1 minus alpha c, c cancels. So you had c alpha square divided by 1 minus alpha is equal to k. What is the value of lambda alpha? Alpha was determined by Coleridge law. What is the formula of alpha, student? In terms of the molar conductivity, this lambda m is the molar conductivity at concentration c. Molar conductivity at concentration c. And what is lambda 0 m? Molar conductivity at infinite dilution. Molar conductivity at infinite dilution, students. If you put the value, then we define alpha is equal to lambda m by lambda 0 m. Put the values, what you will get? Lambda m, lambda 0 m the square, 1 minus lambda m by lambda 0 m. Then what answer will come, student? Solve it. Which is the correct answer, student? What will be the value? Solve it. How will you solve it, students? You can solve it.
Yes, sir.
C lambda m square lambda 0 m square divided by, if I take this LCM, this will become lambda 0 m minus lambda m divided by lambda 0 m. This and this will get cancelled. Then what answer you are getting? This will come down. What is that? C lambda square m divided by lambda 0 m, lambda 0 m minus lambda m. Any answer similar to this? Which one is matching?
Sir, B part.
What I am trying to prove, student, that we have to solve the questions. If we don't know, I cannot answer the question. This is the correct answer because we are getting this answer, student, because we have we know all this, that only I can solve it. So MCQ question, student, important to be solved, student, to be solved. So we have to solve them, then only we will be able to answer the question, students. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Because this is a very good revision. This is the best way of revising the course, student, and you will understand that what type of questions are coming. Instead of the MCQ, he could have given a simple question on this also. A numerical can be given. Or KA is equal to this proof. I have to work it out. This is a weak electrolytes, you know. They are partially ionized. Their dissociation is less than 5%, students. Strong electrolytes don't have any equilibrium. They get completely ionized. We know about it. Next question is on the screen, student. What is the pH of the half cell? So what do you have? Platinum, hydrogen gas, student, and H plus. This is your hydrogen electrode. If E naught, he says, if E naught is equal to, here E naught standard value is given how much? 0.0295 volt. When we used standard conditions, were 298 Kelvin and 1 atm. 1 atm pressure and 1 molar concentration was used. At that time we said it is 0 volt. What is the value of that? We have arbitrarily taken 0 volt. So, student, what will be the formula? How do we define the formula, student? How do you relate pH? What is the standard hydrogen electrode, student? H plus E, this will give you H2 half. If I use two electrons, then I will use that student. And what is the value of this student? E H plus H2 is equal to E not H plus H2 minus 0.059
yes,
by N log of what we have here, P of H2 power half and H plus concentration. And when I use one ATM, that pH2 1 by 2 will also become equal to 1. So I may write it, student, P naught H plus H2 minus 0.059 by N log of 1 by H plus. And what is a log of 1 by H plus, student? Minus log of H plus, which is nothing but pH. What is pH? Minus log of H plus. See the formula to be derived. What it becomes then, students?
Mm-hmm.
E naught H plus H2 minus 0.059. N value here, how many electrons are there? One only. Then pH. pH, student. What is the pH? He is saying, if this value is, this value, student, is, this value is given 0.0295, then what will happen? This value, which value is this? This value is how much? This value is zero. Standard value is zero. So what you are given, student, pay attention, pay attention. This value is how much? Minus 0.0295 volt. This value is zero, minus 0.59.
Yes, sir.
pH. Then what will be the value of pH, student? Minus minus will become plus. 0.0295 divided by 0.059. How much it is coming? What is the value coming? Divide the two. Important question. You see that how difficult it was. It looked very simple.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What is the answer coming?
Sir, this is five, sir.
Huh? Are this will be cancelled by two?
Yes, sir, five, sir. Five.
How five? One by two.
Sir?
One by two.
But sir, how to, if you divide 0.295 by 0.59, is five.
No, this is a 0.0.
But sir, how 295 by 0.59 is five, not two.
If I multiply this by 2, what will I get? 10, 18, 5, 9. So I will get this 0.029, 1 by 2. 1 by 2 will be 0.5.
Sir, if you multiply 59 by 2, you will get 118.
I'm not multiplying, I'm dividing this value by this.
Sir, 295 by 59 is 5, not 1 by 2. Yes, fine, okay, fine.
Okay. Are you will get 0.5 value.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
0.5.
Yes, sir.
What is the value? What is the value of K for the above reaction? This question is missing. This question is incomplete, student. So some data is missing. Data is missing, student. Next question. Is there any doubt in the previous question is important?
No, sir.
Next question. Which of the following statement is correct, student? You know that we defined E cell. These are electrode potential values. Then we also defined delta RG, student, the Gibbs change in Gibbs free energy. That formula you also know, this is NFE. If I use, student, these are related with each other. What is the question here? Which of the following statement is correct? E cell and delta RG are both extensive properties. E cell and delta RG of cell both are intensive property. E cell is intensive, delta RG is extensive. E cell is extensive while delta RG cell is intensive. Okay, what is our answer, student? Therefore, I put up the second question to you, student. What is an extensive property, students? We studied in thermodynamics. What is an extensive property, students? There are two types of properties. Do you remember? We studied extensive and intensive properties. They depend on the quantity of the matter, student. They depend on the quantity of the matter contained, student. How much amount? Amount, quantity means amount of the matter, student. And they do not depend on quantity or amount of matter, student. Remember?
Yes, sir.
For example, temperature, pressure, they are intensive property. Density is intensive property. Mass per unit volume, student. Molarity is intensive. But if I say moles, student, moles is extensive. It depends on the quantity. Entropy is extensive, student. Gibbs free energy is extensive property. This is extensive property. We know it, student. It depends on the quantity of the matter, student. If I take 10 moles, if I take 50, will that delta, will G be same? No. And what about E cell? This is intensive property. It doesn't depend, student, on the quantity of the matter. When we write for equation, it is same. It is same, student. It doesn't change. I can multiply by 2, 3, 4, any equation. E is not changing. It is intensive property. Now we understand what is our answer, student. Question number 7 is on the screen, student. What is our answer? First, E cell and E both are extensive, wrong. E cell and both are wrong. E cell is intensive, delta RG extensive, that is correct. Oh,
yes, sir.
E is the correct answer. We, dekho, every question requires student understanding, and I will not be able to answer without that. Again, my point is very clear. Next question is coming on the screen, students. While charging the lead storage battery.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Lead storage battery is asked a lot in the exam, student. Can you tell me what type of battery is this? Is it primary battery or secondary battery? First question. Lead storage battery, students. Is it primary battery or secondary battery?
कौन सा, विच वन?
लेड स्टोरेज बैटरी।
हम
व्हाट इज द
सर इट
डिफरेंस
इज
बिटवीन प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी बैटरीज? वी टोल्ड यू व्हेन वी डिस्कस द इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री।
यस सर प्राइमरी आर सिंगल यूज एंड सेकेंडरी कैन बी यूज मल्टीपल टाइम्स सो लेड स्टोरेज इज सेकेंडरी
इट कैन बी रिचार्ज्ड,
यस सर
इट कैन बी चार्ज्ड स्टूडेंट, रिवर्सिबल, दे आर रिवर्सिबल स्टूडेंट, डिस्चार्जिंग एंड चार्जिंग। डिस्चार्ज मीन्स यूज एंड यू आर चार्जिंग स्टूडेंट्स, एंड यू नो द रीजन ऑल्सो। वट इज द एनोड इन दिस? देखो क्वेश्चन ऑन दिस टाइप ऑफ बैटरी और सेल्स विल बी वट इज एनोड, वट इज कैथोड, वट इज इलेक्ट्रोलाइट स्टूडेंट, एंड वट आर इलेक्ट्रोलिटिक रिएक्शंस, वट आर द इलेक्ट्रोड रिएक्शन स्टूडेंट। दीज आर द क्वेश्चन विच आर फेवरेट इन दीज वेन एवर सच क्वेश्चन विल बी आस्ड। So we should know these things before we go to the exam. What is anode in lead storage battery, students? You should be keeping NCERT books with you, student, at least, so that you can revise the course with me, revise the complete course with me in a very thorough manner.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
What is the anode? Lead. What is the cathode? You said lead oxide and lead grid. Electrolyte. What is the electrolyte in this? What happens? 38% sulfuric acid, we told you.
Yes, sir.
By mass. And when you use it, what happens? Lead is oxidized to lead sulfate. Lead dioxide is reduced to lead sulfate. They get deposited at the two electrodes. Student. And when I do charging, this is discharging. When I will charge, I will apply a potential from outside. Student. I will attach a battery from outside. Then what will happen? Lead sulfate anode is reduced to lead. Lead sulfate cathode is reduced to lead. Lead sulfate cathode is oxidized to lead. Cathode oxidized. Lead sulfate anode is oxidized to lead oxide. What is our answer, student? Now the reverse reactions are taking place. You have PbSO4 at the two electrodes. What is the correct answer, student? What answer we are giving, students? You have 30 seconds. The first one is the correct answer because the reaction is reversed now, student. You are charging the battery. What was happening in discharging? Now reverse is happening. Reverse is happening. Next question is coming on the screen, student. On the basis of E naught values, the strongest oxidizing agent is? This has -0.35. Iron has -7.7, student. So which will be the oxidizing agent? Means what, student? What is an oxidizing agent?
I'm sorry, it adds oxygen.
Are, where is oxygen? Here we are talking of electrons.
Yes, sir. So an oxidizing agent is
which gets reduced.
Yes, sir.
How it will get reduced, student? It will gain electron. If it gains electron, then only it can be reduced, student. Electronic definition. So which will be gaining the electron more in all these cases, student? Is giving the value. This is negative. Negative value, student. -0.35. This is -0.35. This is -0.77. Fe2 to Fe3 plus. What is saying? Fe2 to Fe3 plus is how much? Minus 0.77 volt. And if I reverse it, it will become plus 0.77. And if I reverse this one, it will become how much? Plus 0.35. Which is more positive, this one or the other one? Which is more positive
sir,
than this one?
Plus, yes, sir. This one.
Then what is our answer, student? Four choices. This Fe3 plus will be the answer because that
yes,
will get reduced, student. Because reduced means it will gain electron more readily because the more positive the value, the more forward the reaction. So it will be the strongest oxidizing agent. Fe3 plus. Strongest oxidizing agent. Student, therefore, you see that such questions we have to think and be able to tell you how we decide which is oxidizing agent, which is reducing. E naught values are very important. They will be there in the paper, student. More negative means stronger reducing agent. And more positive means stronger oxidizing agent. Student, note it down. All these points note down because you will be able to solve many questions on this, what I am discussing. These informations are to be noted and to be used in the exam, students.
Yes, sir.
Answer the questions. What we are doing? Answering the question, practice, revision, complete course, student. Thoroughly. You are going for any competition, it will help you a lot. Any exam, you will appear. Any doubt now? See how good questions are there. They could be put in different way in the paper. I mean, nobody stops the examiners to ask questions in different way. Students, be sure. Lambda of M by 30 solution of weak acid is 8 Simon centimeter square mole inverse. What
yes,
is lambda
sir.
M, student? You are given lambda M value. Concentration 1 by 32 molar, student, of a weak acid. 8 Simon centimeter square mole inverse are the units of molar conductivity. And limiting molar conductivity is given 400 Simon centimeter square mole inverse. What will be Ka, student, for a weak acid? We just derived the formula for Ka. How will you calculate, student? You will get 2 minutes to answer the question. Important question, students. If I take a weak acid like acetic acid, we derived the formula just now, student. What happens? What formula I derived, student? If this is C beginning 0, 0, then this is C 1 minus alpha. This becomes C alpha. Then what was Ka? C alpha square 1 minus alpha. Did we derive that?
Yes, sir.
C is 1 by 32 M. What is alpha? We have to find the value of alpha first. Find the value of alpha. How will you find the value of alpha? Important question, student. We just defined lambda m by lambda 0 m, student. What is lambda m? 8?
Yes, sir.
By 400. So you will get this value. How much is that? 1 by 50, student. So what is you are getting this value is 1 by 50. So
yes,
then
sir.
You will put the value here. If alpha is very, very small than 1, then I can write Ka is equal to C alpha square. What is C value? 1 by 32. What is alpha? Tell me, what is the answer coming now? How much it will come? 4 choices are given. Calculations are involved in answering the question, student. That's what I'm trying to say.
Yes, sir.
What is the value coming now? How do we solve such questions, students? 1 by 32 into 25 into 10 power 2. If I make it 1, 3.2, 2.5, then it is 10 minus 4, student. 10
yes,
minus
sir.
4. And if I multiply these two, students, so the range will be 10 minus 5. The value will come around 10 minus 5 something. I mean, just see the calculations rather than complete calculation. So what I answer, it will be there, student.
Yes, sir.
Multiply and divide. 1.25 into the, then which is the correct answer? Which is the correct answer here? Tell me, students. 4 choices are there. Which is matching? Okay.
Yes.
How
sir.
Much calculation
D part,
has been?
D part.
See how much calculation has been.
D part.
Okay. See that questions have to be solved. MCQ doesn't mean that I can tick mark any question answer. No. So every question requires working out, student. Without working, no answer is possible. IE says in the following question, two or more options may be correct. The positive values of standard electrode potential of copper indicates that. You know that when we wrote E naught copper 2 copper, that was positive. You know, this is important question in transition metal series. I remember that we discussed it in transition elements also. There more than one answer may be correct, student. What answer we will give for this question? This redox couple is a stronger reducing agent than H plus 2 H2 couple. This redox is a stronger oxidizing agent.
Yes, sir.
What do you mean by reducing agent? Reducing agent is that which will get oxidized, which will give electron. Will it give electron? Copper 2 plus 2 is copper plus 0.34 volt. And hydrogen plus E, 1 hydrogen is how much? 0 volt, which
yes,
is more
sir.
Likely to happen. This is more positive. So this will undergo reduction. When it undergoes reduction, student, then what it is? Oxidizing or reducing agent? This will act as an it is going
agent.
Reduction. It will act as an
oxidizing agent.
So what is then? This redox couple is a stronger reducing agent. No, it is not. This is a stronger oxidizing than hydrogen. That is correct. Copper can displace hydrogen from acid. Is it right?
Right, sir.
What right? It is not right. How it is right? How it can displace hydrogen? Can it give electrons? No. It will take the electron. It is wrong. Copper cannot displace hydrogen. That is correct, student. So here B and D, both the answers are correct. depends on the question, student. We cannot hurry up. You can't hurry up any answer. The questions could be like that in the paper. We have to decide student answer without the knowledge. How I can answer a question? I have to see every value and then only I can answer the question, students. If E not self or some half cell reactions are given on the basis, mark the correct answer. H plus E is 0 volt. Water 1.23 volt. This value is positive. Self SO4 1.96 volt. In a dilute sulfuric acid solution, I'm taking dilute H2SO4. Water is in large amount. Dilute and SO4 2 minus dilute means it is less. It is a less student. In dilute sulfuric acid solution, hydrogen ion will be reduced at the cathode. In dilute sulfuric acid, student, hydrogen ion will be reduced at the cathode. Reduction, what is a reduction, student? Something which is positive that will be reduced, because reduction, which ions can be reduced, student? Sulfuric acid will have H plus ion. Water will also give H plus and OH minus.
Yes, sir.
Is it right?
Right, sir.
In dilute solution, hydrogen ion will be reduced. At cathode, reduction takes place. In concentrated sulfuric acid, water will be oxidized. In concentrated sulfuric acid. No. When sulfuric is concentrated, SO4 will be very large, student. Water will be oxidized. Next, C part. In dilute sulfuric acid, water will be oxidized. Water oxidation is 1.23 volt. This is 1.96. But when solution is dilute, then there will be a lot of water. So this will also be correct. The choices which are correct then, student, what are? A and C. Theek hai?
Yes, sir.
Question number 13, student. E not cell for Daniell cell. Which of the following expressions are correct description of the cell, student? Daniell cell, student. What is the relationship? What is the relationship, student? What is the value of Daniell cell? What is value of Daniell cell? E not. At equilibrium. At equilibrium, he is saying.
Yes, sir.
But we say at equilibrium, E cell is equal to E not cell minus 0.059 by N log of KC, students. And this is zero at equilibrium. Then E naught cell becomes equal to 0.059 by 2 log of KC. Or we write 2.303 RT by NF. This also equal to 2.303 RT by NF. What is NF? We are 2F. Log of KC. Then what answers are correct, student? What is the value of E naught cell? 1.1 volt. Which is the correct here? B is correct. You can see the formula.
Yes, sir.
And if I use this formula, student, what will be log KC? Log of KC is equal to 2 into, student, this is 1.1 into 1.1 divided by 0.059. Which answer? Second one. Any other answer? Which is that? out of the four, which is matching with this 2.2 divided by 0.059 is equal to log of KC. Which one is the correct here? This.
Yes,
any
sir.
Answer?
C part, sir.
C is also correct. So B and C are correct. All right, then this is important, student. We end up here and you can see that how can we solve questions in the paper. And we will continue more about this in our next classes. We are going to revise all the chapters and solve all the important and difficult questions which can be given in the paper. Okay, good night. Thank you.
Thanks.
Any doubt?